Okay, so hello guys, today I'm going to show you how to make some beautiful trees and gradient trees like these models you can see on the screen. So it's basically pretty simple and you will just have to respect the same pattern for each trees you want to make. This is also my first video in English, so I'm not really good at it, but I can try to speak like that. So basically you start with a cylinder with a six face around it, and you try to scale it on the Z axis like that. So I go in edit mode, adjust the height of the first face like this. I recreate some vertices and face to get some more to get less vertices, so it's a model improvement for games, and it's easier to see it in the game, and you get more FPS like that. So I scale it down basically to base on the ground, scale it up, add some vertices, some rotation like that. Yeah, you can do something like this almost. Yeah, three vertices is pretty good so far. So if you go in isometric view, you can see it. I did something wrong, but if you go with the tab Z, you can see that your cylinder is now transparent. So you can scale it down. When you go up like this and use some rotation to make it some more realistic. When you continue on this, you will after this scale it as you want and see what shape it has on the top view, so 7 on your numpad. So I decided to rotate the top of the trees, add some rotation, make something different with the base of the trees. So you can basically simply add some rotation, everything you want on it that looks just like a tree at final. So when you arrive at that level, not that level but that I don't know, but when you arrive at that state here, that state, you can basically start to move the geometric center or the origin, I don't know, whatever you want, but it's for me and easier for game development to set the origin at the base of the tree, and easier to rotate it. For example, if you want to use it in Unity. Okay, so now let's start with the bow, I mean the leaves. So you take an isometric bow, icosphere, and you want to scale it up on the Z axis. So you use the touch O and on smooth and try to scale the top to an height you want and obtain this shape. Once you have it, you can move it to the trees, scale it up like that, scale up as well, and you can move it so it can go on the front of the trees. I will retouch it because the top of the trunk was a bit too much rotated, and that's why it was not really good. Yeah, as you can see. So now it's much better. I will now join the two mesh so it can go on the trunk, and you will only have one mesh when you want to transport it to Unity or something. That's fine. So yeah, I scaled it up the origin cursor as well once again, because I changed the two parts, and now we can start by texturing the mesh. So I go at the base of the leaves, try to select some edges and mark them pressing Shift E. I did it twice again, one more. It's easier to make this edge as thin when you want to unwrap it, and I did the same on the trunk, so it's much easier because it's a cylinder shape. So I only select one edges, and here we are. We finished the model and UVs. So now next state is texturing. I go in material and I want to create a new material for the trees. So first I set it to diffuse and select image texture. Now you can see it, but if you go in paint, you will see what we want to do. So as a gradient, I create a 64 by 64 image. That is Y. Zoom in with paint, and then that's the story of gradient. You will have to create some rectangular bar with your gradient. I selected 8 pixel width because it's way enough for what we want to do. First, I try to select a green color, as you can see, and you want to obtain something like this with a high difference because you will see it on the model. So with this technique, you can create whatever trees you want, and pretty trees like futuristic, steampunk, the style you want to create. And I will go really simple on this by creating only 3 or 4 color. I don't remember, but just creating some gradient, red, green color, blue color, whatever color you want, and for the style of your game. If it's a futuristic game, I mean, you can go on something maybe bluish or greenish, I don't know. It's what you want, but I think this model is pretty simple to make and pretty cool to see in a game. As you saw it at the beginning on Blender. I'll continue with one last gradient, still in paint, paint 3D, not paint 3D, sorry, paint.net. That's a free software you can download on the internet, and it's pretty easy to use. You have some basic function, and you don't need some more like gradient pencil, and it's pretty cool for drawing some pixel art. So you want to continue like this, selecting the gradient and color you want, and once you're finished with this, you can save the texture whatever you want, but you need to keep the folder name so you can find the texture again. And then we want to go into Blender. so we can texture the model. Okay, so once in Blender, you want to select U, Smart UV Project or Unwrap, and you will see what it does. So we have a problem now. Oh no, we don't. Sorry, that was in my previous video. So we need to open your texture like this in your folder and select each part of your model separately. As you can see, when you select the material view, you can see the texture and the model on it. I put the UVs on the left, so I can see clearly what I am doing. So first, I selected the leaves and took the UVs and tried to put the gradient color depending on the height of the model. So as you can see, the UVs is pretty long and the top of the leaves is on the brighter color and the lower part of the UVs is on the bottom side. So you will have a gradient color from the bottom to the top of the trees, and this is what we want actually. So I will make the same for the trunk as well. Be sure that the UVs does not get out of the trees and the texture, so you don't have a problem with it. Same method. The UVs, you want the top, you make something like this, and you really want to have the full height of your texture, so you can have a pretty nice gradient. That's all you can make. So I'll make the same for a second tree like that. I select the leaves to the red color, and now you can see the gradient color on the trees, and that's a pretty nice look. So you have a pretty nice low poly trees with a color like that. I will use the white color for the trunk and see how it goes. Yeah, that's pretty nice. So you can have some warm color, different color, you can add something you want, and that's the coolest part of doing this. So guys, I want to thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed this small tutorial. I'm sorry my English is very bad, but I'm trying to be as good as I can. So if you are not understanding what I say, just comment in the comments below and I will try to answer your question on this. Or you can just slow the video down so you can see each steps I made for this tree. Thanks for watching, guys.